Good afternoon. Welcome to On the Media. I'm your host, Wyatt Pierce. Today we'll discuss each one of our interviewees and how media and technology has changed over time. I interviewed my aunt. She's 48 years old.
I'm Megan. I interviewed my Uncle Terry, and he's 42.
I'm Colin. I interviewed my girlfriend's dad, Jim, and he is 41.
I'm Bella. I interviewed my great aunt, Joyce, and she is 64 years old.
Question number one. What stood out to you the most in the interview?
What stood out to me the most is that my uncle got their family's first computer in 1995, and it had no Windows operating system, so they could not use the internet, and they only used the computer to like write papers.
What stood out to me the most is they had one TV in their house. It was in the common room or living room, and when he was younger, he liked to watch his cartoons, and they were usually on only in the morning. Or after school, or even the weekends, as that was the only time that the television would play them.
What stood out to me was how much more tedious schoolwork was back then. My aunt said that just to like write a paper and find information, she would have to go to the library and check out books and use encyclopedias. So it was really surprising to me how much harder it was to find information and how like information just wasn't at their fingertips like it is for us now.
Question number two, what kind of media did they grow up with and what's the difference between then and now?
So my uncle grew up with like the newspaper and the radio, but he also grew up watching whatever his dad put on the TV for them basically. I would say the biggest difference between then and now is just that we have more forms of media and just more newer technologies. Like, we have like three TVs in my house at home, so no one's really fighting over what to watch because we can all go watch our own stuff.
I feel like growing up, he wasn't really interested in the media and technology, as he was mostly outside playing a sport or fixing something. And I feel like the difference between media then and now is back then you only had like your TV station of news or your newspaper. And then versus now, you have all different kinds of apps like Twitter and Instagram.
So my aunt grew up reading the comics out of the newspaper and watching cartoons on the TV. And she would also watch the news with her family around dinner time because that's when it was broadcasted. And I think the biggest difference between now and then is just how quickly information can be spread. Like, I know obviously there's still scheduled programming for the news, but like now they can like just interrupt any like TV show if something like urgent happens. So I think that's a big difference.
When I was interviewing my aunt, she told me she never really read the newspaper or anything. It was mostly just the morning cartoons. That's when she was able to watch it. And then it was she could watch whatever was on the TV before her dad got home. And then after her dad got home, everybody got kicked off the TV and he got to watch whatever he wanted to. And I'd say the biggest difference between then and now is now everybody has a bunch of supercomputers in their pockets that get any information that they want whenever they want. Question number three, how have they adapted to the advancements of media and technology?
So like my uncle has kept up with like getting all newer forms of technology from phones and computers and stuff. Him and his sons also have like gaming systems, so they know how to use like all of that stuff. So he's adapted pretty well to the newer technologies and uses like social media to stay connected with friends and family.
He loves the new media and technology. He scrolls on Instagram Reels almost every day, and he posts on Facebook also almost every day. And he uses it to connect with his old friends, and he uses it to connect with his family that lives across the United States. So,
My aunt has also pretty much kept up to date with technology. She's married to a police officer, so she has always wanted to be informed and have the newest forms of technology just in case anything happened while he was working. And I think, yeah.
How my aunt kept up with technology when they first got the flip phone came out. She thought that was the coolest thing and she got it. And then after the flip phone, when they had the phones that you could slide in half and there was a little keyboard, she thought that was the coolest thing ever. And then after the smartphones came out, she just had to get the latest and greatest one almost every year or every other year after that. Question four, did your attitudes change about media and tech?
I cannot say that my opinion changed much. We both agreed that there are negative aspects to advanced technology and media, but there's also a lot of positives. And I personally think that the positives outweigh those negatives.
I don't think my beliefs changed just because media is a big part of our generation, and I just don't see it going anywhere. And people use media for their daily jobs or occupation, or just to see what's happening around the world. So,
My opinion didn't change either. I agree with Colin that social media and technology is a big part of our culture in this generation, and I think it's a great way to keep everybody connected.
My attitudes did change. After interviewing my aunt and just hearing stories from people even a generation above us, hearing like the stories and hearing the stories about what they did, not everything they did would be videotaped. After hearing all of that, I was jealous of it, so my attitude did change about it. This is On the Media. Thank you for watching.